Is weed bad for you? Depending on who you ask, weed is either a cancer-fighting wonder drug or the devil trying to corrupt us all. And since there's 22 states considering changing their marijuana laws, we wanted to get to the bottom of the question. Is weed really bad for you? Now, before we get started on the biological impacts of what happens when you get high, blaze, burn, light up, scroll, bake, scroll, really? All right, let's break the potential downsides to marijuana into three sections: the brain, the lungs, and cancer. So first off, the brain. So it's assumed that the use of marijuana by teenagers is harmful to brain development. The National Institute of Drug Abuse, or NIDA, warns teens in particular to avoid marijuana as their little brains are still developing. And weed's main psychoactive ingredient, THC, definitely does act on the brain. It mimics the brain's natural endocannabinoids, which regulate our physiological functions, such as appetite, pain, memory, and mood. Now, anything that affects the brain's chemistry should be used very carefully. Our brain is a well-regulated machine, and it's a bad idea to f with that system. So, for example, if you take away the brain's ability to regulate appetite, you can get the munchies, which is why there's a stereotype of the fat stoner. But is smoking weed actually damaging your brain? Well, your brain does adjust to anything you put into it, but to date, the studies that I've seen haven't really been able to prove any serious long-term effects on the brain itself. Now, that's from moderate marijuana consumption. So on a danger spectrum with fatty foods here and heroin here, I'd say weed is definitely somewhere in this category. Okay, so the lungs. If you take a look at lung health, there's a huge disagreement about whether or not marijuana smoke is harmful to the lungs. For example, according to a 2014 study, there's no difference in breathing for those who don't smoke at all and those who smoke marijuana regularly. But lung.org says that all smoke is harmful to the lungs. Basically, there's no clear, demonstrable evidence that potheads have any more difficulty breathing than the average non-user. Interestingly, there may be a reason to believe that marijuana smoke actually has a positive effect on lung health. I'm not joking. Although the causes are kind of unclear, there's research from a national partner journal to suggest that forced vital capacity, or the amount of air that you can force yourself to hold, sees an overall increase in recreational marijuana smokers, assuming that they don't smoke tobacco products as well. Though the American Lung Association continues to push for more research into this, and so they should, the data suggests that there isn't too much harm for the lungs as far as marijuana smoke goes. And now cancer. So you know that tobacco smoking can give you cancer. So is weed smoking also going to give you cancer? If you look at the research so far, it looks like it's actually the opposite. Marijuana can save lives by helping cancer patients eat and sleep and recover quicker from the effects of cancer treatments. There's also some evidence that suggests that marijuana may actually kill cancer cells. As this article on cancer.gov states, cannabinoids may inhibit tumor growth by causing cell death, blocking cell growth, and blocking the development of blood vessels needed by tumors to grow. But as they say, more research is needed. So wait, weed doesn't seem that bad after all. Well, now that we've got the biological facts out there, it's time for me to get up on my political soapbox for just a second. There's a lot of misinformation out there on this topic, and I would speculate there's one big reason for this: corruption. There's pharmaceutical companies who, of course, don't want cannabis taking over their painkillers and other drugs. And the private prison industry, who benefit from thousands of people who are locked up for marijuana-related crimes every year. So for example, look no further than former presidential candidate Marco Rubio. Remember him? He accepted $40,000 worth of campaign donations from GEO, a private correctional corporation. But he didn't get this money for nothing. As House leader, his economic consultant, who was a former trustee of GEO, advised Rubio to award a government prison contract for $110 million to GEO. This is how the private prison lobby works, and they benefit greatly from marijuana still being illegal. This is why many people seem to assume that the potential dangers of marijuana are worse than they actually are, because they've been bombarded with these politically charged misinformation campaigns for a century now. Just look at the ridiculous movie Reefer Madness from the 1930s. It's a fascinating and startling look into American history on this subject. The very name marijuana has a political edge. Cannabis, to the best of our knowledge, actually originates from Central Asia. Yet in the past century, we've come to use the term that the Mexican revolutionaries used, marijuana. Not only did this connect the drug to the Mexican Revolution, which was causing illegal immigration and was not very popular, it's also psychologically connected with communism because the revolutionaries were communists. So our fear of cannabis has been rooted in political propaganda for decades. So I'm just here to bring the science. I'll let you guys make a decision. And by the way, there's way more information on this topic in the description below that you should totally read. And new research is coming out all the time. But what do you guys think? Do you use marijuana for its positive health effects? Our producer, you can't see this, but he's nodding yes. Have you had a bad reaction to weed? Let us know in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching Sciq, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.